quarantine. Now, if I'm being completely realistic, we are all in self-isolation at the moment, which means that 90% of the time I'm probably not wearing makeup, my hair's in a messy bun, and I'm living in pyjamas eating crisps. But when I do my makeup, this is, for the most part, the makeup that I would wear. There are a couple of new products that I have thrown in there as well, because online shopping is catching me hard in isolation. So, without further ado, if you want to see how I got this makeup look, then keep on watching. Okay, first things first is I need to tie my hair back. Now, I have made some questionable decisions in my life, and I feel like spending money on this headband is probably one of them, but it does the job. So now we're going to go in with the L'Oreal Hydrogenious Aloe Water. This is actually new, I've never used this before, but I was looking for a new daily moisturiser, and this one came highly recommended, so I'm going to give this a go. Just going to pop that on and rub it in. Oh wow, okay, so you don't need that much of it. So it's left my skin feeling very hydrated. You really don't need a lot of it. and it also smells quite fresh. So yeah, I think I quite like that actually. And then I'm also going to go in with my Enspa Cherry and Almond Lip Balm just to prep my lips for lipstick, because Lord knows they are dry as hell. This stuff was like £1 from Asda at Christmas. And I'm fairly certain that like every woman that I had to buy for this year got one of these in their stockings. And I'm hoping that
they're using them, because
to think that this is going to waste is such shame. Okay, if you guys can see
my mirror in the shot for any of this,
I do apologize. So for foundation, I'm gonna go in with this one, which is a new one. I actually ordered it off Amazon last week, and it's the Farah foundation. I've seen a lot about this. I've seen a lot about them using people that haven't actually used the product to like promote it and stuff. But I've also heard some good things about the actual foundation itself. So I bought the shade, if I can find it, Buff Beige. And I bought Buff Beige because it's summer, so I'm tanning, and I'm hoping that this looks better
with a tan. It says soft
matte longwear liquid foundation, coverage foundation, naturally flawless oil controlling and lightweight feel. So we'll see if any of that actually holds up. Go in with this to start with and we'll see how we get on.
So,
okay, this might actually be quite a good match for my tan shade. So we will see, because sometimes when you blend out and it oxidizes, you change your mind real quick
when you see yourself in natural light.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in with my Superdrug
blending
sponge to put this onto my face. It does look gross, I swear.
Again, it's been washed, but
even the microwave trick by Mrs. Hinch doesn't work for me, so let's blend this in and see how it looks. Seriously impressed with this foundation. Okay, but seriously, that's actually a really nice foundation. I'll see how it wears up, but so far, for a tenner of my money, you're worth it. So I'm not going to go in with a bit of concealer, although if I'm completely honest, it doesn't look like I would need much. And I'm going in with the Rimmel Lasting Radiance Concealer in the shade 10 Ivory. And I'm just going to put this under my eyes to conceal those bags, and brighten up my under eyes. Just a little bit. And then I also like to put some on the top of my eyelid just to prime for eyeshadow because I don't use an eyeshadow primer. So now I'm going to go in with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, beloved powder, I use it every day, and this random brush from, so basically I bought a pack of makeup brushes from Amazon. I bought eye makeup brushes and face brushes because my one's severely needed updating and it's not as if I can go shopping right now. So I'm going to take one of these, it's like an angled multi-purpose brush, and I'm going to go in and just set the concealer under my eyes. And set the rest of the base that I have put down. This powder is just amazing. I've never found one that works quite as well as this one. But if you have any recommendations for anything actually, but especially powder because I'm interested to see if there's any other ones that work really well. But if you have any recommendations, leave them in the comments because I'm always looking for new stuff to try. Is that all set? Okay. I have blanked out most of my face. Now it's time to add the colour back in, but the way I want it. So, I'm going to go in with this bronzer, which is a new bronzer that, again, I bought from Amazon last week. And it's the Bourjois Delice de Poudre. Lol, don't speak French. It's basically the one that looks like chocolate. So we'll call it the chocolate bronzer. I'm going to go in with this, and I'm going to go in with a big fluffy brush. I'm going to go in with this. This is in the shade Light and Medium Skin Tone. I'm just going to swirl my brush around in there and hope for the best. Ooh, that's actually really nice. Okay. So I don't contour on a daily basis, I contour if I'm going like on a night out or if I'm taking photos for something or anything like that, but generally speaking I tend just to throw a bit of bronzer on because, I mean, contour is just a lot of work, isn't it? And I must say that foundation has given a lovely base for it to go onto as well. I'm really impressed. I really like that foundation. Well, if there is an area that I should really contour on the daily, it should probably be my nose. But I don't. So, I obviously don't hate it that much. Okay, now I'm going to go in with blush. And the blush that I've been loving at the moment is this Triple Threat Blusher by W7. The name of the shades are Live, Laugh, and Love. So do with that as you will. I'm going to go in with, yes it's broken, I'm going to go in with this lighter shade and this medium shade and I'm going to like mix those together to get a shade that I like. I tend to stay away from the bright pinks because I am very heavy handed with blush and if I'm not careful it goes too far real quick. I'm also going to go back in with my powder brush and just blend that out a little bit to make sure that there are no harsh edges. I don't actually know if it makes much of a difference, but I do it all the time, so. I'm going to go in with highlighter, and the highlighter that I've been loving at the moment is the Revolution Reloaded Highlighter, and this is in Dare to Divulge, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's like a champagne goldy colour. Love it. And I'm also going to take a fan brush and I'm just going to rub it in here and then pop that on my cheekbones. I mean, you can't go wrong really, can you? My nose and then just on my cupid's bow and under my lips because I don't overline my lips, so I have to try and make them look a little bigger with eyelet, which is fine by me. So I'm now going to go in for my brows. And for my brows, I've always used the PS eyebrow pencil from Primark in the shade Taupe. And I absolutely loved it, and about a month or two ago, I went into Primark to pick one up because my last one had run out, and they stopped doing it. They've changed them. So, also, I dyed my hair, so I probably needed a new shade of eyebrow pencil anyway, but I would rather have made that choice by myself. So I decided to pick up the new one that they have, and this is in the PS Brow Sketch, and this is in the shade Brown. I actually got this one when we went to Dublin. I actually got it from Penny's, not Primark, but it's the same thing. They do the thick one and the thin one. I prefer the thin one in the new formula, but I did prefer the chunky one in the new formula. It has a spoolie on one end, fine tip point on the other. So I'm going to comb through my brows and then fill them in for you guys. Okay, brows are done, not my strong point, don't do anything particularly special, they usually do end up bigger by the day. Anyhow, moving on to eyeshadow, and I'm going to use this eyeshadow palette here. Now this was one, again, I picked up on Amazon, and it says Saprofi, I don't know. Anyway, it says In Your Elegance Nude 18 Colour Makeup Palette. And I actually do really like this palette for like everyday looks, especially in the autumn. It's got the nice rich golds and what have you. I don't do anything particularly fancy on a daily basis for my eyes. So first I'm going to go in with quite a big blending brush. And I'm going to mix the shades Amber and Amethyst together. And just pop this in the crease of my eye. So next I'm going to go in with this shade here, which is called Royal, and I'm just going to take a small amount of that and pop that on like the outer corners of my eyes, and this is just supposed to give my eyes a bit more depth and a bit more natural shading, I suppose. And then I'm going to take a little bit of that brown under the lash line, just on the outer corners. Like so. And then I'm going to go in the big blending brush that I used before, and I'm just going to blend all of this out so that it is not so harsh. So now I'm going to go in with the shade Musk, which is this
like champagne-y gold colour here. And I'm actually going to use my finger for this because I just find that with shimmery shades, it's easier to do it with your finger than it is to do it with a brush. So I'm just going to take that and dab that on the centre of the lid where we haven't yet placed any product.
And this is just going to open up the eye a little bit and give me a little bit of that daily sparkle. So now I'm going to go in with my Urban Decay Naked Smoky palette, and I'm going to go in with the shade Whiskey here, and I'm going to take that on an angled liner brush, and I'm going to use the shade to line my eyes instead of using a liquid liner, which is something that I used to use loads, and now I tend to do it a lot less frequently than I used to, just because I find this is easier, it doesn't transfer as much, It's quicker and it looks a lot less harsh and a bit more natural, or as natural as you can be when you cake this much makeup onto your face already. And I'm left with something like this that makes me happy. So, next is mascara. And the mascara that I like to use is the Maybelline Lash Sensational Lash Multiplying Mascara. And this is just in the shade black, I believe. And I like to go in with this one just because I feel like it's comfortable. I always know I'm going to get good results from the mascara. Who doesn't want the best possible results from their mascara? Because I want length, I want volume, and I want definition, and I don't want to compromise on it. So I start off with this as a lip liner, then I go in with the Bee lipstick, which you can find at Superdrug, and this is in the shade Baby Boo. And then lastly, I'm going to go in with this lip gloss, which is actually just from H&M, and it is the Runaway lip gloss, and I don't believe it has a shade, but it's the nudie type one, and I'm just going to run over my lips with this. And that completes my everyday makeup routine. If you guys enjoyed this video, then don't forget to subscribe down below, along with pressing the bell and notification bell. That way you are notified every time I upload a new video. I have recently started a TikTok account, so that, along with all of the other handles to my social media, will be in the description bar below, along with a detailed list of all of the products and brushes that I used in this video today. And until next time, guys, bye guys.